Hi everybody, it's Belinda. I haven't made a video in a while. I want to make one real quick. You'll have to excuse if I have a little bit of a lisp. I'm trying to get used to these teeth. Anyway, I have put apply the fan. I'm not trying to be a supermodel or anything. I'm just in my nail room, as you can see, and I got my little fan going. Take these glasses off. In my new glasses, y'all. Aren't they pretty? Anyway, I'm gonna be having surgery Wednesday. It'll be my third umbilical hernia repair surgery. And I posted something about, I believe, yesterday or today about, I said that this lighting is really bad. I'm sorry, guys. No. Sorry. Nope, that's not gonna get it either. Well, maybe that's good. Good enough. I'm not gonna be under that long anyway. About my surgeon had scared me about the surgery. And I had a few emails and a few private messages wanting to know what I meant by things going bad. What I mean by things going bad is, like I said, this will be my third umbilical hernia repair. My first one was in 2001, and my second one was in 2013, I think. And the reasons why it's going to be more difficult is because one is because I've had so many repairs already. Two, because they're going to be dealing with a lot of scar tissue from all the abdominal surgeries I've had in the past, including my reconstructive surgery, all that good stuff. They're going to be dealing with the scar tissue. They're going to be dealing directly with my abdominal wall this time. And he said that my bowel could be perforated. It's already, I can't even say it right. It's already going through the hole already. But it could be worse. He said that they can get in there and it could accidentally get nicked or just any of those things. So all my other surgeries that I've had, I've always been nervous. But this one, I'm scared. And to me, there is a huge difference between being scared and being nervous. Y'all might not agree with me, but that's how I feel about it. So I'm nervous and I'm scared on top of it. And I'll be spending one night in the hospital. He wants me to stay there in case I have any complications, which obviously he thinks I might. He said more than one day if I need to, however long it needs to be done. And I will probably be doing videos if I'm not too hyped up on meds, which I hope I am, because I know it's going to be painful when I come out of there. So, that's pretty much it. I'm just nervous about that. And I've had a few people ask me why I'm having to have a third one. Well, I have been a really horrible weight loss surgery patient. I have not followed not one stinking rule probably in the last year. So that's not good. But this is a medical issue and I have to take care of it and I have to lose at least 30 to 40 pounds after I heal up and keep the weight off so that I won't have to have a second, well, that'd be my fourth by then, the other umbilical hernia surgery where they would put a permanent mesh in there. I see right now, I mean, I've been in pain for the last 2 or 3 months and waiting to have the surgery for the last month. It's been let's go 1 to 10, usually between a 6 and an 8 most every day. I can't walk more than 5 or 10 minutes. Thus, I can't exercise, even if I wanted to, because it's too painful for me to do so. And like I told him, I'm just one of those people who, one of those weight loss area people who has to not only restrict their food and drink their water, but I have to work out. Otherwise, it doesn't seem to want to work for me. But there are some weight loss surgery patients who all they do is restrict their food from their surgery and they lose weight and maintain and are fine. There's other people like me that I have to do the whole ball of wax. Otherwise, it just doesn't work. And plus, people who, like me, I'm 46 years old, right? My metabolism is down the road, and it's not going to get any better, it's going to get worse. So, I'm all right. I've been here almost 6 minutes now. I just wanted to fill people in on that. And the reason why I'm having to have it again is because I've gained 60 or 70 pounds of the 150 that I initially had lost. So, in case you're all wondering, if you have any suggestions or any comments, I'm always open to them. And just keep me in your prayers. Yeah. What do you think about my teeth? Anyway, I'll talk to you guys later. Like I said, just keep me in your prayers. Bye.